Dear student, today we are going to learn chapter number 2, parallel lines. In this, we are going to see practice set 2.2. If you have not subscribed my channel, please subscribe it today itself. Let's start. Here we have question number 1. In the figure y equals 208 degree and x equals to 71 degree, are the lines m and n parallel? Justify. Let's see the proof of this. Here it is given that y equals to 108 degree and x equals to 71 degree. Look at this figure. Here x and y are interior angles. If the sum of these two angles is 180 degree, it means if the interior angles are supplementary, then the lines are parallel. So here we are going to find out the sum of angle x and angle y. Okay, so angle x plus y equals to 108 degree plus 71 degree. Therefore, x plus y equals to 179 degree. It means x plus y is not equals to 180 degree. It means sum of these two interior angle is not a supplementary. Or you can say, here the sum of these two interior angle is not equals to 180. Hence, line M is not parallel to line N, as it does not satisfy interior angle test for parallel lines. Here we have question number 2. In the figure, if angle A congruent angle B, then prove that line L parallel line M. Let's see the proof of this. Consider angle C as shown in the figure. Look at this figure. I am going to name one of the angle as angle C, right? You can see that I have taken an angle C opposite to angle A. Angle A congruent angle B. Angle A congruent angle B. Why? It's a given. Okay, you can see in this figure angle A and B are congruent. It's a given. Angle A congruent angle C, because they are vertically opposite angles. Look at this figure. Can you find angle A and C in this figure? Yes, you can see that angle A and angle C are vertically opposite angle, and we know vertically opposite angles are congruent. Now look at the equation 1 and 2. In 1, A is congruent to B. Angle A is congruent to angle B. In equation 2, angle A is congruent to angle C. It means angle A congruent angle B, congruent angle C. It means all three angles are congruent. So I can say that therefore angle C congruent to angle B from equation 1 and 2. Look at this figure. Here angle C and B are corresponding angles, right? And we know if the corresponding angles are congruent, then the lines are parallel. Therefore, line L parallel line M. Here we have next question. In the figure, if angle A congruent angle B, angle X congruent angle Y, prove that line L parallel line M. Look at the proof of this question. Here angle A congruent angle B, right? It's a given. Look at this figure. Can you find angle A and B? Yes, angle A and B. What kind of angles are they? They are corresponding angles, right? And we know if the corresponding angles are congruent, then the lines are parallel, correct? So which two lines will be parallel in this figure? Line L and line M, since corresponding angle formed by them are congruent. Therefore, line L parallel line M by corresponding angle test. It's equation number 1. Angle X congruent angle Y, how we came to know? It's also given. Look at this figure. Can you find angle X and Y in this figure? You can see that angle X and angle Y are alternate angles, right? And we know if the alternate angles are congruent, then the lines are parallel. So which two lines will be parallel over here? Line M and line N. Why line M and line N are parallel? Because alternate angles formed by them are congruent. Therefore, line M parallel line N by alternate angle test. That would be equation number 2. Look at equation 1. Here line L parallel line M. And equation 2 is line M parallel line N. Okay, so line L of equation number 1 and line N of equation 2 are parallel to line M. It means all three lines are parallel. So I can say that line L parallel line N from 1 and 2. Therefore, line L parallel line M. Here we have next question. In the figure, if ray be a parallel ray D, angle C equals to 50 degree and angle D equals to 100 degree, find the measure of angle ABC. We will do construction here. Let's see what is the construction. We will extend line AB and let it intersect seg DC at point F such that A dash, B dash, F dash, H. Look at this figure. Here I'm going to extend line AB. Can you see that? I've extended line AB and it intersect seg DC at point F. And I've taken one more point H on this line such that A dash, B dash, F dash, H. Now look at this figure. Here ray DE parallel ray BA. You can see in this figure ray DE and ray BA are parallel. Therefore ray DE parallel ray AF or line AF, because they two are same line. Therefore angle D plus angle DFH equals to 100 degree. Okay, you can see this figure. Can you find angle D and angle DFH? You can see that angle D and angle DFH, they are interior angles, right? And we know interior angles are supplementary when the lines are parallel. Therefore angle D plus angle DFH equals to 180 degree. Now we will substitute here measure of angle D, which is given as 100 degree. Therefore 100 degree plus angle DFH equals to 180 degree. Now we will shift 100 degree to that side of equal to. Therefore angle DFH equals to 180 degree minus 100 degree. Therefore angle DFH equals to 80 degree. Look at this figure. In this figure angle BFC, congruent angle DFH. Look at this figure. Okay, can you see angle DFH and angle BFC? They are vertically opposite angles. And we know vertically opposite angles are congruent. So here it is given angle DFH equals to 80 degree. Therefore, look at this figure. Therefore, angle BFC will also 80 degree. Okay, now look at here. Here we have triangle BFC. Can you find triangle BFC? Yes, you can see angle ABC. Angle ABC is an exterior angle of a triangle BFC. And we know measure of exterior angle is equals to sum of its remote interior angle. So what is exterior angle in this figure? Angle ABC. And what are the remote interior angle in this figure? Angle BFC and angle C, the short name, that is BCF. Okay, therefore angle ABC equals to angle BFC plus angle C. Now we will substitute here measure of angle BFC and measure of angle C. Therefore angle ABC equals to 80 degree plus 50 degree. Therefore measure angle ABC equals to 130 degree. Here we have next question. In the figure, if ray AE parallel ray BD, ray AF is bisector of angle EAB and ray BC is bisector of angle ABD, prove that line AF parallel line BC. Let's see the proof of this question. Here ray AE parallel ray BD and seg AB is a transversal. Look at this figure. You can see that ray AE parallel ray BD and BA is a transversal. Therefore angle EAB, congruent angle ABD, because they are alternate angles and we know if the lines are parallel then alternate angles are congruent. Okay, therefore measure angle EAB equals to measure angle ABD. If they are congruent, so their measures will be equal. It is equation number one. Now here AF, can you see in this figure, ray AF is bisector of angle EAB. Therefore angle FAB, okay, FAB is half of measure angle EAB since AF is a bisector. of angle EAB, equation number 2. Okay, Basutoman divides angle, divides given angle EAB into equal angles. Therefore, each angle means angle EAF and angle FAB will be half of angle EAB. Now look at this figure. Here, ray BC is a bisector of angle ABD. It means this bisector divides angle ABD into equal angles. That is angle ABC and angle CBD. And each one would be half of angle ABD. Therefore, measure angle ABC equals to half of measure angle ABD. Since ray BC is a bisector of angle ABD, it's equation number 3. Okay, therefore measure angle FAB equals to measure angle ABC from 1, 2, 3. Okay, look at the right hand side of equation 2 and 3. What it is? Half of angle EAB and half of angle ABD. So here angle EAB and angle ABD are equal. That we showed it in equation number 1. It means right hand side of equation 2 and 3 are equal. Therefore, FAB equals to angle ABC. Okay. Therefore, angle FAB congruent to angle ABC. If the measures are equal, so definitely angles will be congruent. Look at this figure. Okay. Here you can see angle FAB congruent angle ABC. Just now I have proved it. And what kind of angles are they? They are alternate angles. And we know if the alternate angles formed by two lines are congruent, then those two lines are parallel. Therefore, line AF parallel line BC by alternate angle test.